So we've learned that this is the fundamental equation to thin airfoil theory. And now we need to find a solution, a distribution of gammas that satisfies this equation. So when we integrate those gammas from 0 to c, according to this equation here, this integral, that it is equal to something that depends on the angle of attack and the change in slope the slope of the camber line at any point along the airfoil. So now this is a little tricky, but back in the day what they did was they used a change of variables, and we'll see why that's helpful here in just a moment. But we're going to say that x, instead of working in x, we're going to use a change of variables into theta. And we're going to say that any x location can be expressed in terms of theta according to this equation here. And notice our variable differentiation here, of integration, we're also going to need to change that guy over. So that gives us dx naught is actually equal to, if we use this change of variables, c over 2 sine of theta naught d theta naught. Okay, so then we just, we're going to plug this in now into the left-hand side, and what we come up with is 1 over 2 pi times the integral, and we need to change the bounds of our integration, or the limits of our integration, and we can plug in an x naught of 0, and we'll get a theta naught of 0, and plug in c, and x equal to c, and that gives us a theta equal to pi. So we're going to integrate from 0 to pi of gamma in terms of theta naught now, times, now we've got this dx naught here that's multiplied by sine theta naught, so I'm going to put that up there in the numerator, sine theta naught divided by, and all of these c over 2s are going to cancel here. We've got one in the numerator here from this term that goes up here, and then we've got these ones in the denominator that are used for x and x naught here. Those will all cancel, and what we'll get is cosine theta naught minus cosine theta in the denominator, once we simplify things, times d theta. Okay, so that's our left-hand side, and that is all equal to what we had on the right-hand side, v infinity sine alpha minus dyc dx cosine alpha. Okay, so the nice thing about setting it up this way is that that this integral here is actually a very well-known integral, and it has a solution in terms of a Fourier sine series. And so we can write the solution to this as gamma of theta is equal to 2v infinity times a0. So we've got some constant term here, 1 plus cosine theta over sine theta. I shouldn't have called that constant. That's just the lowest term in the Fourier series. It's a term out front. Plus all of the terms in the series starting at 1 to infinity, a sub n sine of n theta. And I'm not going to work through the derivation of this. This is just a well-known integral or solution here to that integral in terms of a Fourier sine series. Now, in order for this, for the left-hand side of our general equation in terms of theta to be equal to the right-hand side, our constants here, a0 and an, must have certain relationships in order for this equation to hold true. And again, I'm not going to work through that, but you can plug this in, work through the integral, and come out with constants or expressions for a zero, we'll find that a zero has to be equal to sine alpha minus 1 over pi cosine alpha. The integral from theta equals 0 to pi of dyc dx d theta. And that an in general, or all those n terms, have got to be equal to 2 over pi cosine alpha times the integral of theta equals 0 up to pi of dyc dx cosine of n theta d theta. Okay, so these are the this is the general solution here, and then these are the constants, these Fourier coefficients. This is how they've got to be related, or what their solutions have to be in order to make this this general equation up here, or fundamental equation of thin airfoil theory, true. Now we can take this one step further. I'm actually just going to whittle these constants down using a small angle approximation, because that's going to help us develop equations for lift and pitching moment from that. So let's assume that our angle of attack is small. So that means that the cosine of alpha is about 1, and the sine of alpha is about alpha. And so that gives us an A0 term of sine alpha is now going to be alpha minus cosine alpha is just 1, so we're going to have 1 over pi times the integral from theta equals 0 to pi of dyc dx d theta. And then the an terms are going to be 2 over pi, and that cosine of alpha goes away to 1 due to the small angle approximation. And then we're integrating from theta equals 0 up to pi of dyc dx cosine of n theta d theta. Okay, so these are the small angle approximations for these constants, and the ones on the left do not assume the small angle of attack approximation. But in any case, these constants now can be used in conjunction with this general solution here, this Fourier sine series. And that can be that is the solution where we've come up with these constants that now satisfy this fundamental equation. So this solution for gamma, this is the distribution of vorticity, and you can see, by the way, that this satisfies the Kutta condition, which requires that theta at the trailing edge is equal to 0. Anyway, we could work through that, but we could show that this satisfies that theta at the trailing edge is going to be 0, and that these constants now have been chosen here in order to satisfy this equation up here. And so with this distribution and these constants, we can now evaluate the lift and pitching moment on the airfoil.